In today's video, we will be making a sprinkle candle. First thing you want to do is take this candle dot and stick it to the bottom of your wick. And then stick it inside and on the bottom of your mason jar. I had to use a pair of scissors to get it to really stick on. You can also use craft stick or whatever you have on hand to stick it in. You'll notice the mason jar already has sprinkles in it, but I learned that I needed to do that step later. So what you want to do is take some of your melt and pour wax and put it in a microwavable safe container. And then you will microwave that for about 90 seconds. Then you can add some more and microwave for about 60 seconds. Your microwave may take a little bit longer or less time. You might want to make sure you're watching it the whole time to make sure. I stirred it in just so it would be evenly spread out. And again, you'll microwave that. And you'll do this step one more time. You want to use pretty much all the wax you have in that bag. Luckily, my container is about the same size as the mason jar, so I know it will fit. And I microwave this one for about 60 seconds, but you want to make sure that is fully melted through. Now to go back to the mason jar, you want to use some light corn syrup and pour it into your mason jar. This is going to help keep the sprinkles kind of glued to the edge of your mason jar. You may need to add a little bit more, and it will take a little bit of time, but you're going to try to brush it all the way around the inside of your mason jar. I did have to go get a brush to make sure all the sides were covered. And then I had a little bit extra, so I poured that out. Then you will sprinkle all your sprinkles to cover the edge of the jar. Now going back to your melted wax, you want to add a few drops of your fragrance, and this one of course is going to be cupcake scented since we are doing a sprinkle candle. I put enough in there to make sure I could smell it, but not too much that it was overpowering. And then you're going to mix it in. I used a craft stick to stir. And then you're going to pour the wax into the jar. I recommend doing this over a sink or trash can because you will make a mess. Make sure not to overfill. And then I took that craft stick and put it on one side, and I ended up grabbing another one to hold the wick in place. And here it is once it completely dries.